Hi everyone. So as I've promised, I'm recording this video about extracting meshes from The Sims 3. Just like with The Sims 2, you need to have The Sims 3 with all necessary packs installed on your computer. It doesn't matter where you have it, in Origin or in Steam, any version of The Sims 3 will do. If you want to convert something from The Sims 3 store, you obviously need to have that file on your computer too. Or if you want to convert some custom piece made by another Sims 3 creator, you need this file as well. Just make sure that their terms of use allow convertations to other games. But first, I'm going to show you how to extract a mesh and its texture from the game itself. You need to have the Sims Resource Workshop program. You can find it on their site. Here we need to click on Create New Project. Then we need to click on Clothing. And then we need to click on Next. The filters in this program are not that specific as they are in Sims 4 Studio, but we can see that the clothing is sorted by species. Click on Human in the left window, and then we need Young Adult category, and then you choose the necessary frame. I'm going to look through female stuff, but you can go to the male category, of course. Here we have clothing categories. Most of items can be found in the everyday category, but if you want something specific, like a swimsuit for example, just go to the swimwear category. On the right, we see all items from CAS, but unfortunately, they are not sorted like shoes, tops, bottoms, full body outfits. You can sort them by pack, but you need to know the number of the expansion pack. You can find this number in the file names. For example, I want to convert something from Supernatural pack. So let's go through all these items to see if I can find something from this AP. I found top from the AP, and you may see the number in their names. It's EP7. So Supernaturals was the 7th pack for Sims 3. Just type EP7 in the blank field, and here we can see all cast stuff for female Sims from this pack. For example, I want to convert some top. I'll choose this one with lace, so just click on your item and then click Next. Don't change anything here, we don't really need it. Then click Next again, and then OK. Here you can take a look at your mesh. I won't convert it because I feel like there are gonna be huge problems with weights of its sleeves, but we will use it as an example. Click on the Textures tab. Here you can see the original swatches from the game. You may extract them if you like, but I rarely do it. Anyways, we need to find the main texture. It's called Multiplier. Just click on it twice and then click on Export. I usually save textures as PNG because I think it helps to preserve the quality of images. Then click on the Mesh tab, and then click here and choose High Level of Detail. It's the best quality mesh you can extract. Click on the button with a little box and a red arrow, and make sure that you change the type of your file to Object. like we did it in my Sims 2 tutorial video. Now let's talk about store files. We need Sims 3 package viewer program. I'll leave the link to it in the description box. I have all store files which were ever released for The Sims 3, and here you can see them. So I have only sets which are packed in Sims 3 pack format. I need to get only one item. I don't need all of them, so I need to extract it from the whole set as a package file. Let's open, for example, this set, Mid-Century Dining. It has clothing items, so to find them easily, just click on the button with a swimsuit and trunks on it. The quality of these pictures isn't the best, but it gives the general idea and silhouette of the items anyway. Let's try the blue dress. Click on extract and save your file. I would suggest to change the name of the file because it's just numbers and letters and you may have hard time looking for your file later. But be careful and change it only before .package. Once I thought that even if I deleted it, the file format would be fine, but I couldn't open it after, so don't repeat my mistake. And well, we don't need this program anymore, and you may close it. Let's go back to the Sims Resource Workshop. It's easier here to extract meshes, and I'll tell you why later. Click on Create New Project again, but instead of closing, choose New Import. Here, click on Browse, change the format to Package, and click on your store file. It's not a Sims 4 package, so click No. Then click Next and wait until your package will open. So here lies the problem. DSW doesn't open textures for store files. I don't know why, but it sees the mesh itself. So open the Mesh tab and choose High Level of Detail and export your mesh as an object. We don't need the workshop anymore, so I'm going to close it. The last program you need is Sims 3P. I extract textures with it, but in theory you can extract meshes with it too, but I don't do it and later I'll show you why. Click on File, then Open and select your store package. So here you can see lines with Geom word in their names, and somewhere in these lines can be found the highest lot. But there is nothing in its name that can say me that, so I don't want to check every single geom to find the best lot, so that's why I extract meshes in the workshop. Anyways, let's get back to our textures. Fortunately, Sims 3P sees the textures for store files, and here you may find them. Right-click on your gray texture and choose Save Image. Name your file and save it as PNG. I'm going to show you quickly how to add the object file to the scene in Blender one more time, since in my previous video something glitched and there was a black screen. Click on File, Import, Wavefront Object. Here you can see both files which I've extracted. I'm going to add the dress to the scene. I'll delete all parts which we don't need, like legs, arms, etc. You surely need to adjust your mesh to fit a sim body better, but I won't do it in this video. Check my other one where I show the whole process in details. It's basically the same for the Sims 3 Convertations, it doesn't matter. So if you have any questions, let me know. Have a good day, night. Bye!